Well, reactions have continued to trill. The CBN Naira for Dollar scheme, the latest coming from Nasima. Nasima believes the scheme, if properly implemented, may have positive impact on the modest exit from recession, boost the foreign exchange import, and hopefully result in reduction of pressure on the Naira, but says other areas which deserves attention in the quest to increase forex inflow as the non-oil export. The Director General of Nasima, Ambassador Ayo Olukomi, joins us now. Good morning, Ambassador Olukomi. Thank you very much for joining us on the program.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much for having me.
Well, as the leader, of an organized private sector, how did you perceive this move by the CBN?
Well, thank you very much. Before I answer your question, let me also join all of us to wish our women International Women's Day. Happy International Women's Day.
I sincerely hope we will concretize
the abstractions by supporting women-owned businesses. Absolutely. I cut my teeth in the UN on the third committee, Commission on the Status of Women. And so I do understand the challenges and the progress and the challenges ahead. Let us continue to be, let us continue to choose to challenge for progress.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much. Well, of course, we were quite excited because of this particular period. Every dollar we can lay our hands on is very important. And global remittances has been proved to be very, very important. If you look at the figures, is in trillions. Africa also is in billions. And countries like India, China, your Philippines, all of them use the global remittances as part of pushing for their development aspirations in terms of investment as well, apart from the fact that it also helps in terms of supporting households. So we were quite excited when this policy came in, that this, of course, will encourage, improve remittances. Don't forget remittances in Nigeria is moved from about 20 billion, and the projection is that very soon we can hit as much as about over 30 billion. I mean, the contest. So we are quite excited that this is a strategic move by the CBN to attract foreign to improve remittances. And of course, against the background of the fact that remittances can do a lot in terms of churn out foreign exchange.
According to your statements, in the quest to increase forex inflow, non-oil exports should be giving more attention. Now, where does it seem like we're getting it wrong in our non-oil export strategy?
Well, if you see, we had put out a statement, Nasima had put out a statement, that we welcome this. It's a good thing in terms of our focus on our remittances. But we also spoke that we need to work exactly and more as far as the non-oil export is concerned. It is still yet to be tapped. It's over 10 billion. But how much are we earning as far as non-oil export is concerned? We have to work on this particular area. It is very, very important. I was listening to you when you were reading out the figures in terms of how much did we import, how much did we export. And we have now slipped. I mean, you can see what the newspapers are saying today in terms of trade deficit. So we need to work on this to ensure that the non-oil sector will see the attention which is talking about. I also followed you when you look at the, when we're talking about, Olu Phillips was talking about the APAPA gridlock. They are connected, because if you want to improve earning from oil, from export, then you have to facilitate and ensure the infrastructure is right. Because if you don't get it right in that particular area, what we express is what we continue to express. Our non-oil export will continue to be depressed. And that is why we have to look at the crisis of the infrastructure and make deliberate effort, as far as that area itself is concerned, to be able to improve significantly what we earn from the non-oil export. And maybe perhaps I should also branch and say that we were talking about the oil prices yesterday, which of course hit $70 and it slipped back again. Our budget is, I think, about based on $40, thereabout. And we said, good news, but please do not let us be jubilating. We must remember the boom and bust cycle of crude oil. so that the non-oil area should focus on. And if you look at what we talked about in terms of the area of agriculture, the potential is huge. There is also the agric value chain in context of agric business. Well, these are the areas. Tomorrow, we never know what can happen. Maybe somewhere something is, a new oil field is found, and then oil prices will nosedive again. We welcome it. It's good, but please let us also look at the non-oil. The Export Promotion Council has a zero oil plan. Let us work on that. And Nigeria can, we have the potential. We have the potential. Look at our products in terms of, you know, cocoa, adding value to it, our hibiscus, our ginger. I work in the Chambers of Commerce movement, and we have many other people. Recently, I just got the news yesterday, the Nsukka yellow pepper has been included in the geographical indication system. Identified the Nsukka yellow pepper. This is a very good example of the potentials which we are. So let us focus on that particular area.
All right, let's look at the appropriateness of this strategy in managing, you know, the foreign exchange market. Of course, it's in a bid to increase FX inflows into the market. And then some economic analysts find this policy strategy very unusual, where you have policies made around promo gimmicks and say such promos like buy to get one free or something, basically done by manufacturers, and having the monetary policy go that route is quite unusual. What's your take on that? And how well do you think, or what's the appropriate way you think the central bank can actually manage the foreign exchange market?
Well, you know, ideas are the greatest resources you can have. And if you don't have resources, you become resourceful. So the CBN itself must have been monitoring this particular area. And I think there are some countries which has also tried this, like Bangladesh and a few others, to attract foreign direct investment. I mean, you know, you have to make a try. You have to make a move. And I think this is a move in the right direction. But my only worry is that why limit it to May? That is, well, let's see what happens when the things start being implemented. And as a former career diplomat, and of course, I got a few calls from some of our, I last served in Australia. And I got a few calls from some of our nationals, Nigerian in the diaspora, who are in Australia, who called and said, look, listen, Ambassador, is this real? I said, yes, it is real. It is real. And I said, why are you asking? He said, well, this is encouraging in a way, so that we can, because the issue is that what do you do with these remittances? That is key and very, very important. What do we do with it? It is very important. One, apart from the question of supporting household, I also have seen that from my own experience, it is possible to direct them specifically into investment at home. Investment at home, maybe your community in a particular area. I had somebody who used to live in Sydney and he wanted to come and invest in his area, local government area, and we were discussing that. I said, it is possible, and it is possible for you to do. And that's why we are saying in the Chambers of Commerce movement that the Chambers of Commerce, which is located all across the country, is a solid platform to be able to channel these diasporas into investment, into various, into development purposes. It is. And I think that we wait and see what the CPN does in this particular area. I think the next 2 weeks will be a very, very good time to be able to do an assessment in terms of what exactly has happened, how many people have been attracted as far as this is concerned. And of course, maybe perhaps we can do a midterm review in the next 2 or 3 weeks in terms of how has this policy impacted positively in terms of attracting remittances. But like I said, it's always very good to also share. Countries like Bangladesh and a few others have also tried this in the past, and I think they've had positive impact in terms of influence in terms of what exactly the resultant influence of this. Every dollar we can attract at this particular period now, if it becomes necessary for us to be very innovative about it, this is a kind of innovative step by the CBN, and we commend it.
Well, that wait and see is actually one of the things. Perhaps that's why the CBN is, you know, they want to check until the 8th of May. But there's also the fear of some of the risks, you know, one of them being round tripping. What do you think? You know, some people have said this will lead to, some people might get too innovative and then round tripping might take place. What do you say to this?
Well, I think the CBN must have thought it out very well in terms of blocking the loopholes. I mean, you can have a 100%, I mean, some of these policies, occasionally you do have some things which will, people are looking for the possibility of how to you know, take advantage of it in a negative way. But I think that the CBN itself on its part has done a good work in this particular area. And if you look at the advertisement in the newspapers, you will see many of the banks have jumped onto it. Very many of the banks are advertising, look, if you do this, this is what you get in terms of a naira for dollar scheme. So I think we should not say because of the fear that people will take advantage of this, we will not take a step. We must take that step. We must take that step. And if we discover that people are, you know, taking advantage of it, then we will see, we'll block that hole.
Okay.
That's the view. That's the perception. We are keen in the Chambers of Commerce. Nasima is very keen to see how we can, of course, take, of course, work with our members, because we also have, Nasima has diaspora chapter. We have diaspora chapter. The last time we were in Australia, we discussed with some of our people in terms of what you can do in this particular area. And the mining sector was one of the areas in which we encouraged them, please come in and invest and be part and parcel of it.
All right, Ambassador. All right, I'm sorry to cut you off there. We're running out of time. Thank you very much, Ambassador Olukomi, for sharing your time with us this morning on the program. Thank you. We do appreciate it.
Thank you very much. And once again, congratulations to our women.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
All right, thank you.